Hello everyone, it's Vicky. Happy fall again. We're still in October and I love it and I'm so excited because today I wanted to talk about the Jibun Techo as well as an alternative to the Jibun Techo. Now with the Jibun Techo, it is something that I've been pining after for quite some time. I'd say almost as long as I had the Hobonichi. When I first discovered the Hobonichi in 2014, the Jibun Techo was a little bit different how I stumbled upon it, and that was because Rowena from she makes the Sojourners, these guys right here, this was my first one. I received inside one of her notebooks, and I don't have it in here, but it was an insert that had idea written at the top. It had Tomoe River paper. It was in the B6 slim size, and she was selling those inserts to go along with her Sojourner. And I got this several years ago. And when I was like, well, where did she get these inserts from? I stumbled upon a Jibun Techo, and not a lot of it is in English, a lot of it is in Japanese. But I started finding different types of feeds that spoke about the Jibun Techo, and I love the idea of the system. I think I've been doing that type of a system for a long time where I have one main planner in the center, and then I use a traveler's notebook usually, and I have two notebooks on the side. I don't use one of them as like a life notebook as the Jibun Techo kind of suggests. Instead, I use one for more of kind of the journaling and diary keeping, sketching, and then the other one for ideas like notes and video ideas, things like that. And I like to keep those two like thinner notebooks in with a actual planner where I have my calendars and how I plan out my days. I love that style of planning. I love that idea, and that's normally how I've had, at least for the past couple of years, had my traveler's notebooks broken down. And so the Jibun Techo was not easily attainable. Some Etsy sellers in the most recent year I've noticed have been selling it. It's relatively expensive through the Etsy sellers, though it came out to somewhere around like $50 or $60. And so I started really kind of doing my own thing. And I recently even posted a video where I talked about putting a B6 cafe notebook in a personal Malden, and I removed the rings and really like that size. And so recently I went on to AliExpress, which is like a Chinese kind of market where you can find a lot of lookalikes, I want to say, where there are actually even Malden looking planners that they have on there that are real leather that you can purchase at like half the price, if not like a third of the price. You do have to wait a little while, even though with this guy I waited about a week. I ordered this from AliExpress. It's a Jibun Techo that's undated. And then JetPens, of course, posted that they're selling Jibun Techo kits. Now I think the kit is the way to go, just because especially if it's like your first time, because you're actually going to be less expensive than just buying the book, unless you already like, no, you don't want to use the system, you don't want the cover, you don't want the little board, then just get the book. Otherwise, I highly recommend getting like the whole kit, because it's way less expensive and you're getting like the whole kit and caboodle kind of a thing. Now, I'm going to post a video. I think it's the vegan organizer. She did a phenomenal job of explaining like page by page what everything means and what the layouts mean. I'm going to link her down below. And I want to give her full credit for everything that she did there, because I think she did an amazing job of explaining everything. So I'm going to have that there in case you want to see like what everything means, because a lot of it is still in Japanese. I know a lot of the Hobonichi Techo still is in Japanese, but much of it has been already kind of translated. But I love the B6 slim size. If you hear anything, that's my daughter in the kitchen. I love the B6 slim size. I thought it'd be really fun to sit down. I haven't opened either one of these yet. I'm new to this. I thought it'd be fun for you to see my reactions to them, because they're brand new to me. I'm very familiar with the B6 slim size. I love that size. But I thought it'd be fun to kind of do it together. This, the one from that I got from AliExpress, looks a lot thicker than Jibun Techo. This Jibun Techo has the calendar in there as well as the two kind of the life and idea notebooks. So I'm really curious to see how the two differ, which one I'm going to prefer, which one I like. But I love this size, and I'm thinking I'm going to be going this route for my planning for 2018. We'll see. But I thought it'd be fun just to give you my experience, my like initial reaction. I also want to go through and show you what they fit into. So this is the B6 Slim Sojourner. I also have a folio that's a B6 from Rowena. I have my personal Malden. I want to see if that fits in there. I have B6 from Buteo Bunker. I also have another B6 from Buteo Bunker, as well as a B6 Slim from my Duke Duck from Apple Pig Leathers. So that'd be fun to just kind of play around in the different covers, see how they fit. I think the Jibun Techo, that whole system, will work great in a traveler's notebook, because you have all those strings, so you can kind of string in your diary as well as your life in your notebooks. I think that's really phenomenal, and I like that a lot about it, because I have a ton of traveler's notebooks and I love them. But also, if you were to purchase from JetPens, you get like the little kit. So I'll show what the cover looks like and what you get in the kit. It does do a little bit of an explanation on the front, which is really nice. It says it's a 3-in-1 life log diary. I think this is really truly like a way that I love to plan my way and try and incorporate my life to be broken down in this way. And I'll explain it more when I turn you around and show you. But it has like your diary that has the weekly, monthly, and yearly schedule, a monthly project, my dream, money plan, weekly plan, Japan map, lists of favorite phrases, recommendations, books, movies, gifts, and promise, looking back, route maps, personal info, a life book, which is dream, 100 wishes, motto, life plan, my news, a family tree, emergency contact, password hints, financial management, medical record, and then an idea book, which is a grid memo. So I'm going to go through that. I'm going to show you how I use those idea books before in a traveler's notebook, because I have them. I should show you what I'm talking about. I have them in here in my Duke Duck, are these little idea notebooks. And I first saw these with Rowena from Sojourner. I saw them in her shop, and that's where kind of my rabbit trail led me to the Jibun Techo. That's how I first heard of it. There are a few videos that I've seen popping up, especially more recently on the Jibun Techo on YouTube, but it looks like a really phenomenal planner. I want to check it out. I want to share with you my first like initial impressions. So let's get to it. Okay, so here we are side by side. This is the official Jibun Techo. This is just the one from AliExpress, the one that was less expensive. I believe this is about $11 or $12 plus, maybe it's like free shipping, or you can choose for like the $2.50 to have like tracking, which I recommend getting something with tracking when you're coming overseas. This whole kit and caboodle was on JetPens, maybe $40, somewhere in that price bracket. I'll have everything linked down below though, so you can see it. This came in like one of those priority mail kinds of boxes. This came in an e-packet, like a China e-packet. It's a padded envelope, and then this is wrapped in bubble wrap, so there's no damage to anything that I can see. So I know a little bit about the Jibun Techo just from the videos that I've recently been seeing pop up. I joined the Facebook group for the Jibun Techo and the Nolte, and I did see that JetPens had a video out. So I have a little bit of an idea, and like I said, when I first started researching this, I was very curious, so I have done some research on it, so I have some knowledge of it. I do know that this version of the sorry, I have crumbs here from Hank's cookie because he drops his cookies here. So the Jibun Techo should have, I believe, Tomoe River paper in the life, or maybe not in the life notebook, but for sure in the note notebook, and then in the actual diary is Tomoe River. And then this is a different paper, but also a really nice high quality paper. And here, oh my gosh, this is just so similar. It's unbelievable how similar they are. The paper is definitely not Tomoe River paper in here. We're gonna do some testing, but you can see it's undated. So I love the size first and foremost. So this is in a cover. As you can see, this is not in a cover. It is just in a Coptic stitch, so it's gonna lie flat. There is a like casing over this, so it's hard for you to see, but I can see in person the Coptic stitch that goes along the spine, just kind of like the Midori MD notebooks. You should see that similarity. Here we have, again, like a little beautiful, like, I love, I mean, everything that Japanese people do with stationery is incredible. So this is the mini, also known like as the B6 slim size, just to give you kind of a reference in size. 3-in-1, again, a diary, life, and idea notebook by Kokuyo. Then this is a cover. So this will slip off of this. I don't want to take it off because I wanted to take pictures for a blog so you guys can have pictures on there, but this will slip off, and then you have like plastic business card holder. So this is a plastic cover on top of a cover in here. I'll pull that out though. And then this is a board that you can use to write on because it is Tomoe River paper. And it has a little elastic closure in there. So that kind of slides in the back pocket here. Again, like the efficiency with everything like Japanese is incredible. How everything fits so nicely. It's all like nicely compartmentalized, excuse me. And then I'm assuming the elastic closes over so we keep everything nice and neat and clean. Really, really love that. Just adore that part. Trying to see if I can just slide this off. There we go. I'll just put that back on for my vlog for images. So you can see it says 2018. There is a front pocket in here. You could probably throw, you know, a quick notes in there. You could probably throw a passport in there. You could fit an iPhone in there. Lots of things to fit in there. The way the notebook is designed, again, you have one insert that slides out that you use in the front here that is a life insert. Again, I'm not going to go through details of every single thing because I'm going to link the vegan organizer down below. She does a very thorough, but you basically, this is something you would keep for life. So you would take this out and use it in your future notebooks with the light, with the Jibun Techo. I just lost my train of thought. And what you would do in here is record anniversaries, you know, in all of the months of the year. I believe you record like your dreams, a personal motto for each year, so probably like your word of the year or goal of the year, something like that. Then this tells you how to use it. We obviously cannot read Japanese. Life's dream and wishes. The paper in there, I think it's like Miu paper. It's a really nice quality. It's a really high quality. I'm assuming they chose this because it would last a lifetime. Not that Tomoe River won't, but Tomoe River is a lot thinner than this. I feel like the quality is incredible. Really, really nice to the touch. This is like my news from ages 40 to 44. Family news, world news. So just kind of a really, and then this is really beautiful too. They have for like each year of your age, so 35, 36, 37, 38, and so you put like your news, family news, and world news, so you can just kind of look back on this, and you know, it's just really awesome. They have, you know, for 20 to 24, I am unfortunately no longer 10 years old, but what I can do is put things in for my kids, so I could put in, instead of just family news here, I could put in news for my kids here. You can also use it however you'd like. You can just cover that up with white out and use it however you want. This is really awesome. A Japan travel map. I love the light grid in here. September anniversaries, October anniversaries. Just, I love the colors in this. Very muted, like pastel. Beautiful, beautiful colors. Love this. And I really need to revisit to see how to use the rest of that. So that kind of pops into the front part here. And like I mentioned, it's like a 3-in-1 kind of booklet setup. So this would go with me in my next Jibun Techo if I choose to use it next year. And then here's the Jibun Techo itself. So it tells you how to use it, and then it gives you an example page, which is really, really nice. I gotta say, I love the size so, so much. I love it. It's just such a beautiful size. We then have a 2017, 2018 overview, 2019, 2020. Hard to believe that that is something that will happen. Then we have, it looks like, a way to future plan for 2018. So we have January here, and we're planning it vertically. I love that. We see that in the Hobonichi Techo as well. Then we have an age chart, which is really kind of cool to show, I believe, how old you would be and what year. My dream, 2018, great place to maybe put your goals, or you can even use this as a place to, you know, catch things that happen in 2018, whatever you want. Money plan, so again, I have to reference and see the jet pens and other videos to see how that's being utilized. And then we have a weekly plan in here. So this one looks like it's just a, it doesn't look like it kind of follows through. Maybe just an example page or blank page, or maybe the week before you get started where you would not be able to use the planner just yet. Favorite phrases, then we have a recommendation list, a book list, which is always comes in handy. I love having a book list, a movie list, gifts received, gifts given, great for the holidays, right? So great place to keep all of your gift giving. Also for birthdays, any other time you're giving out gifts. We had a lot of weddings and baptisms and things. Promise list, really kind of cute. Not sure what I use that for. We have like a blank place to do some tracking. Then here we look like, let's see what we're doing here. So again, it looks like maybe some a place to do some tracking of items, because now we have the entire month. You could also maybe even, if you prefer, to use this for some sort of planning, marking out your vacations, marking out, like blocking things off so you can kind of have a general overview perhaps, or, you know, marking off when your kids are in school, when they're off from school. I think that's how I'm probably going to use this, is use a color to just have a quick glance to see like when their days are off. And you can just use this here on the side to fill in what you want. So maybe like paydays or cleaning days, days, you know, that your husband's out of town, things like that. You can kind of probably use this section for. I'll have to get creative with that and see, but I like that a lot. And that goes up until January of 2019. Ooh, and then we start November. Look at that. It's a 2018, but we start November. Well, lucky for me, because it's October right now. Today's the 21st, I believe, of October, the 20th. I'm not sure. So I can use this right after Halloween. That's incredible. I didn't realize that. I thought I'd have to wait till the new year, but I don't. So I have a monthly overview here. Really nice. Okay, so this is awesome that I get to start using this in November. It's perfect timing. So we have a beautiful month overview on that beautiful Tomoe River paper. Really nice color scheme. We have like through the kind of work week, we're in like a nice green. Weekend, we have a different color to mark that off. I love that. This is very pleasing to the eye. The light gray scale on here is very easy on the eyes, and the muted colors are very easy for me to look at. I also love that the paper isn't like a stark white. It's something about a stark white piece of paper that hurts my eyes. I don't like looking at it for a very long period of time. In the month overview, it looks like there are perhaps like a mood tracker here, and some other little trackers that I can't totally tell. It looks like some sort of a Japanese caricature. And then we have some future planning down here at the bottom. Love that. Sometimes when you're on the phone with somebody and they say, you're kind of at the end of the month, for example, like in October, and my sister says, oh, November, blah, 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 what's going on? I can quickly look at the month to see, okay, if it's a Friday, Saturday, or Sunday. Friday, probably not, because I usually work. Saturday, maybe. Sunday, definitely, I can do something. Just at a quick glance. I like using those for future kind of references there. You also have some checkboxes here on the left-hand side, just for like your monthly maybe goals, your monthly to-dos. I like to have my, when I do a brain spill, I like to then put those tasks here for the month. Anything that's big. Big things, for example, for me are, and these may not be for you, but they are for me. I have little kids, so big milestones. I like doing photo shoots, especially now with the with holidays coming through. So I do, in October, for example, I do a costume. Like, I put them in their Halloween costumes. I do a photo shoot. We do a family photo shoot. I do Christmas cards. I like doing, my daughter's going to be turning 1 in November, so I'm going to do a 1-year photo shoot for her, like kind of a birthday themed type of a photo shoot, or maybe a Thanksgiving theme. I haven't decided yet, but those are some things maybe I would put down here for big events, getting Christmas cards out on time, buying Christmas gifts, things like that. I would maybe keep here on the side so I can check them off, because those are like big things I want to get done for the month. I love that all the months are together. That can be a pet peeve for some. For me, it's brilliant. I know and like where to go in my planner when everything is in one section. It's brilliant to me. When it's broken apart like that, it's a pain in the butt, because then you have to tab it because you don't know where to look for it. You can still use tabs, and I believe it's one of the accessories, but you don't have to use tabs if you've got kind of the color coding that you can see here on the side. They use like a color coding. So the November is a light green. So I know my weeklies are in that light, they're in that light green color as well down here. So you can see that they all kind of match up when you were to bend the page. So you could put tiny little tabs there. I believe it's an accessory you can purchase in addition to, but we have all of our months together. I personally love that. I hate when months are broken apart into in the middle of the weeks. It's kind of a pain in the butt for me. I like having it all here, because to me, monthly planning is essential. Weekly, okay. Monthly, fine. But the daily, fine. But monthly is essential. So when I'm in here, I can figure out, okay, what's going on in May? What's going on in January? It's very, very well thought out, and I love that they have all their months together. It's brilliant, in my opinion. We then get into our weeks. So we go straight from months. We have March 2019, which is really nice. And we get into our week breakdown. Love, love the size. This is going to force me to use a really small nib type, which I love. We have a overview of the month over here, which is really, really nice. And it also looks like it kind of goes into the next month as well, which is excellent. Or it actually looks like, I apologize, it looks like October blending into November. Brilliant. I mean, the Japanese just are so brilliant and efficient in their planning. It's unbelievable. So we have here, we start off from October 30th, work our way into like the first official week of November. And so we have like weather up at the top, which is great. You can just kind of highlight what it is. Nice way to kind of keep track of things. From my understanding, this is like tracking your sleep. And then each of these little guys here looks like it has a time on there in military time. So we're going to go 7, 8, 9, 10 up to, you know, 1600, which is 4 o'clock, 1700, 5 o'clock, up until 2400. So we're doing military time. Perfect for me. I'm a nurse. That's how we think. We only think in military time. I don't even know how to tell time anymore other than military time. So it works out great for me. At the bottom here, I'm not 100% sure. Maybe a mood tracker because it looks like it has some faces with a smile and indifferent kind of a look and then a frowny face. Then I see another... perhaps maybe sunrise, sunset type of a thing. And then the stars on the bottom, not sure. Again, just some fun research, or I can fill it in with whatever I'd like to. Again, with the color scheme, really well thought out. So we're kind of in a muted, kind of an indigo, gray, Payne's gray type of a color. Then we go into November here. So we go into like the week color and then the start of a new month. And then we have our week and then we go into the weekend. So we kind of see that go through here. So here is a full week in November. We have the week, like the work week, weekend. Work week, weekend, and we kind of make our way into that. Then once we get into a new month, once again, we break into like the color scheme. Once again, very well thought out. So we finish off November with a light green. We get into November, which is a pink. We have the weekend. Then you see the full week is in December, is pink, like a salmon pink weekend. So the weeks are coordinating with the month color, and then the weekends are their own color, which is really nice. Love these muted colors. They're absolutely beautiful. I love that kind of like Payne's gray color for January. Then February kind of has this taupe color going through the top, and we go into a pink again for March, and green. So just really beautiful variations of these really nice and muted colors. I love this size. I just absolutely adore B6 Slim. It's a beautiful, beautiful size, very efficient, just enough space for me to work and write in. Love this Tomoe River paper. Let's kind of take a peek here at the end. We have a couple of notes pages, but again, because this is a three-part system, we don't need a lot because we have this idea notebook in the back, and this is where you can do all your notes. So if you're in meetings, you're going to be back here, you're going to have your diary here, and you can take these out and fill them in as your year goes on, however many meeting minutes you take. And the job I had before, I was filling notebooks up like crazy. We had tons of meeting minutes to do. This is a looking back on 2018. Really nice just to kind of write a few lines on your year. You have two pages here to do that. We have some awesome maps. I love maps. Even if I never am in Tokyo, it's really awesome to have maps. I just like how they look. We have, you know, the L here in Chicago, so it's very similar in my opinion to what the L looks like. World time zones, that's really awesome to have. There's a lot of viewers all across the world that I have, and it's fun to know where the time is there for them. Personal data section, and then we get into the idea notebook. The idea notebook, I've bragged about these for a long time now, and I'll show you in my Duke Duck here from Apple Pig how I have been using them. So this one I've been using more kind of like that journaling. It's got that great Tomoe River paper in here, and I've just really enjoyed it for that. This was really fun, by the way. Hulda Folk. I will share that in another video, but like this, I've used it, and then also just for catching ideas, things for my kids for school. I love having the light gray line go through there to kind of separate where I need to do a header or some dates in there, and I love those idea notebooks. I think they're fantastic. fantastic. So here's kind of a brief overview of the system. This is Tomoe River paper. It looks like not a lot, but it actually is a fair bit. It's going to keep you busy for a while. Then we have that little board back here. Again, really well thought out, and it's all so nice and efficient. We have a couple of bookmarks in here just so we can mark our month and the week. And then we close it all up, and it is just perfection, in my opinion, absolute perfection. Now, to take a look at this guy, I love this. It's noticeably thicker. I initially thought maybe it was because they added some notes or something in the back, but I'm going to show you really quickly. So the cover is exactly like a Midori MD, is what it feels like if you're familiar with those. We get into here some future kind of ways of planning. So it's just a diary. Again, really nice because it's undated, so you fill it in. So I could start this in March and make my way through for March. And then again, we have some color schemes for your weekly. The thing is though, because it's undated, we don't color scheme with the month like you do in the Jibun Techo, because obviously you're choosing when you want to do it. But you can still find where the month is based on the color coding here. So the months all have this kind of Payne's gray color. The paper in here, now that I'm feeling it, kind of feels like it's something with an M, Miyumo paper, which is in this Life notebook in here. It's got a little bit of a gloss to it. It feels like a really nice quality in here. I'm sure that it is. It's stitched again, so it lies nice and flat, but all undated. The grid in this is a little bit of a darker gray. Still has the same idea with like the mood tracking there. I love, again, the muted color scheme. So we're still on muted color scheme. And then, so we have all of our months in here, and then we're going to go into our week. Very, very similar once again, but great because it's undated. So you fill in the dates. I actually really love this. I'm going to go, obviously, I think with the 2018, but I think I'm going to hold on to this and go with that undated because I love undated planners. It's my thing. I love that. So we get tons of weeks that are undated. But here's something fun for my folks who love a good daily page, because guess what? They have a daily page in here. Look at this. Ha ha! How cool is that? Something that Jibun Techo definitely does not have, but you could do if you really wanted to by using your little idea notebook. You could always create dailies back here if you really wanted to. Just sharing. But this is so cool because you can still do a Hobonichi / kind of daily type of journaling if you really, really wanted to. And you get a lot of pages to do this with. I don't know because I haven't counted, nor did I read on there, but I would imagine you get at least a year's worth, because I can't imagine that they only give you a half year's worth, but I think you'll probably get a full year's worth where you can do your daily, like, if you needed the space, you could do a daily workup for your day. So you have like a time grid on the side here. Again, you're in military times, so you're 8, 10, 12, then you go into 1600, 20, and 2200. It's your military time, which is great. I love that. My brain thinks that way. You have a section up top here to kind of do your main things that you need for the day. You know, here you can use this as your schedule. Here you can use for notes. You know, whatever you want to do, there is a place to do your dates up at the top, as well as your weather, or if you wanted to draw, whatever you want to do. But it's got a daily section. I think that's really awesome. The paper in this looks really, really, really nice as well. I want to do a spot here where I do some pen testing, so I'm going to do it on the back here because this would be a hard page to use. And let me grab a couple of fountain pens because I feel like those are pretty good bleeders to test out this paper. Let me grab that. All right, I just have a couple of pens because I don't want to drag this on. If there's a specific pen you'd like me to try out for you, I'm happy to do that. Just write that in the comments. So this one here, this is a pen that I received from Tombow. I love drawing with this pen. It's like a brush pen. But what's great though is that it is relatively permanent. So let's see back here what that looks like. And then there's a gray on the back as well. So we'll see. It's a pretty wet pen though. That's why I went with it. Then this is one of my absolute favorite pens ever. It's a Pilot Multiball. It draws and writes on everything. It's a fantastic pen. I love how fine tipped it is, but how wet it is. And I've been writing out my dates, so I write them out like this usually, and I love how that looks. Then I also have a fountain pen in here. This I received as a gift from Apple Pig Leathers, and it has autumn oak in it. I just love how that ink looks in this pen. It's just one of my favorites. So I'm going to write Hello, autumn. Just because I love it. Pretty wet pen. And then I have a gel pen in here, just like a cheapy one, but I thought I would. It was like a Target dollar spot. But we will test that out. Okay. So let's see. Drum roll, please. Yeah, I could tell. It's a really nice quality pen. So you can see there's nothing. There's really not even like that much shadowing. There's a little bit of shadowing on there, but nothing to cry about. It's very minimal. I couldn't imagine that they would have these and not have good quality paper in there. I find that many people in Japan, Korea, China, like, their paper quality is really way higher than us here in the United States for the most part. But yeah, this is really nice quality paper in here. I'm not surprised just by touching this and feeling it. It's just heavier than the Tomoe River paper. So the book has a little bit more weight to it than this one, but not at all by much. So now let's check out some covers just to see. I'm just curious what they look like. And let's see here. So the book is thinner, like I mentioned. But I do want to see, is it the same? I'm trying to see if it's about the same size as these Life notebooks. Yeah, they're about the same. So let's see if we have the Sojourner. I just feel like my only issue that we're going to run into with this guy, because it's a little bit hefty. Oh, actually, no, it does fit. And you could probably fit it with another insert, too. Let's see. I'm going to take this guy out. And put this guy in. You obviously want to find kind of the center. I'm going to put it on the center elastic here. Just curious to see how that fits. Definitely fits in there. But I think you'd only need one in here. And it fits. It fits in a Sojourner B6 Slim. Really nicely. Very nicely, actually. And then the Jibun for sure will fit in here. It's a lot slimmer because, again, we have the days in here. So the Jibun Techo is about this size. And this is added on here. This much is added on here for those dailies. And because I can fit all these inserts in here, I know that this will fit in here just fine. The Life notebook will fit in here just fine. You can use the whole system in here without any issues. Okay, so that works. Let's see now. I have a folio, a B6 folio that I love from Rowan. I have these idea notebooks everywhere. I love them. Just love them. And let me see. Yeah. I like having these little knickknackers in here. I was thinking actually about using this for my Jibun Techo. So let's see how this fits in here. So this is B6 again, not B6 Slim, it's a B6. So this will work perfectly for my Jibun Techo because you can see here, if I slide another book in here, like so, okay, they're going to fit perfectly. They're going to bulk up really nice, and I think this is my cover choice. For sure, I believe. So you can see they will fit nicely in here. This is, again, not the real one. But this is like, I don't want to say a pain in the butt, but it is a pain in the butt to get it all out from out of the cover. But I know that they're size-wise, they're the same. It's just not as bulky. But that's a really nice option. I love that very much. Next, we have one of these Buteo bunkers. So, here's a B6 Buteo bunker. Let's see how this fits in here. I think we're not going to have any problems in the B6. Oops, that's the beauty of B6 and B6 Slim, is that I like using the B6 Slim inserts in a B6 because the B6 has, you can see there's a lot of room here, so I can throw in a couple of these notebooks, like these Life notebooks, if I wanted to, or those idea notebooks. I can throw a couple of them in there. Let's see here. I can throw a couple of them in there, and because my B6, I know if I lift it, it's blurry for you guys, but you can see how it can accommodate having those inserts in there. This is why I love B6 and B6 Slim so very much. A lot of you were asking me if I felt like the B6 Slim was enough room for writing for folks who love B6. Yes, absolutely. For me, without a doubt. The B6, this is a B6 insert. So just to give you an idea of how like different it is, you're just trimming a little bit off. So it's really so minuscule for me that the sizes are almost like this. There's so very little difference for me. I just really sometimes get the love and the passion for like the portability a little bit. Not that B6 isn't portable, but for some reason that B6 Slim is just such a nice size in the hand, and it just fills the pages so nicely. Like if you look at this, it just fills very, very nicely. I don't know what it is, don't know why, but it just does. It just works very, very beautifully, very nicely. I like how it fills, and I just continue to love that size. I just really, really, truly makes me very happy. This has orchid paper, which is a little bit different from the Tomoe River, but it's a version of Tomoe River, just a different GSM. But just to give you an idea, I think it's plenty of space. I don't have an issue with it. Again, it's a personal preference. What I'm going to recommend for folks who are interested about the Jibun Techo but aren't sure if they want to jump ship on it is to order a couple of these notebook, these idea ones. Order a couple of those and stick them in a B6 planner if that's what you have. Stick them in there and do a three-part system for yourself and check it out that way first before you invest in the Jibun Techo. I say that because I don't like wastefully spending things. Like I said, I've been researching this planner for a few years, and it's something that I finally decided to get because I've been doing this system for a long time and have been enjoying it. And when I finally saw that it was on JetPens, I thought I'm going to give it a whirl. This is Tomoe River paper. It's a B6 insert. This is kind of more of a journaling type of a notebook where I decided to kind of separate my journaling from planning. I'm going to do a video on this also coming up, but I like that the craft world and the planner world have merged. I like it, but I think there's something that has been robbed of the planner by combining it. I don't know. I've got a video coming up on it. You guys can tell me then what you think. Now, here's my current system. It's in the Personal Malden. This is the B6 Cafe notebook, and it is really similar to the B6 Slim. The only thing is, oh no, it's not. It is. It's exactly the same. I thought maybe it was just a hair shorter, but it's not. It's exactly the same. This has beautiful, this comes from Nanami Papers. It's a blank grid notebook. I love it, and I've been currently planning in it just to prep me once again to see if it was like something I wanted to do with a Jibun Techo. I think that I'm going to use both for a little while. I know that seems strange, but I'm trying to take you through all of my like planning ways. And so I love having just my week layout like this, but sometimes I need to like write a little bit more. My brain needs to do a little bit more of like that bullet journal type of planning. So what I like with this is that I'm able to freely do that. This is why I love free form planning, is that I'm able to really dictate how to plan rather than be dictated to. I feel like when we're structured like this, someone's telling me how to plan. Someone's giving me how much space I have to plan, and someone's telling me how to do it. Versus me having blank pages, I'm telling my planner how I want to plan. That's why I like the free form planning. It's just something I think I should have control over versus someone telling me how to do it. But I also like the clean, concise way that this calendar is set up, that I can just glance at tasks and be able to do them at the same time. So I may just be using this to do some brain spillage, and this just to have it kind of organized with me, type of a planner. It may or may not come with me to work. Haven't decided that yet, but because this system has been working really well for me, this is not going to stop for now. It's going to continue with me until I figure out what I want to do. But I've been really enjoying using this. I think it's just
worked really, really well. But just to share with you, this will fit into a personal Malden as well. So if you want to use your Malden in a different way and pull out the rings, you can do so. You can also pull out the rings without like destroying it. Mine's not destroyed, and if I wanted to pop the rings back in, I'm sure I could. So that's just kind of an idea of covers you can use, how you can use it. This is an alternative to the Jibun Techo. So again, this is lesser expensive. You do have to wait a little bit, but it's undated, so it doesn't matter when you start using it. But it's an option if you're interested in perhaps giving it a whirl. Like I said, though, I really have been interested in the Jibun Techo for quite some time now. I want to give it a whirl. I want to give it a test. It's just something I've had on my mind and really wanted to, you know, check out. I love that idea of the three-part system. I think that someone's really hit the nail on the head in that, and, you know, kind of keeping things separate with planning. And that's why it has helped me come to the conclusion of why I maybe don't like that the craft world has blended with the planner world. I feel like it's taken away a little bit from the actual planning part. I like the addition. Like, I like the fact that people are adding to their planners and making it part of their lives, but something is missing. And so I think with the Jibun Techo, separating that out, compartmentalizing different sections has really helped a lot and brought some light for me. But I'll have another video on that. Thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you again soon. Take care. Bye-bye.